Peace be with you.
With you and with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, proclaimed by Saint John.
Glory to you, Christ our Lord.
I am the Good Shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father.
Glory to you, Christ our Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters and dear children, when our former Archbishop Mar Kuriakos Kunnasheri took charge as the bishop of Kottayam, his first speech was very famous, because he quoted from the first verse that we read today from the Gospel of John, chapter 10, verse 11, and said that now I am appointed as a shepherd of the Kananaya Catholic community, and I lay down my life for this community, for my people. And so that was quoted in the media, because that is the true spirit of Jesus Christ. Every word in the Bible is very relevant and meaningful. So when we, and the following passages are the explanation of this thesis, this statement: I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. So I am, when Jesus says I am, he is using the same name that God gave as his name to Moses. Because when God first appeared to Moses and asked him to lead the people of Israel, Moses asked, when I go back to Egypt, and ask the people to get organized to go back to the promised land, so, what name should I say? Who sent me? And then this God said, I am who am. That means I am in existence from the always. I have no origin, my beginning and no end. I am the one who is always in existence and no one else. So I am, when Jesus says, I am the light of the world, I am the way, I am the truth, or I am the life, Jesus means, I am means I am God. I am God the Son. And then he says, I am the good shepherd. The good is meaningful because Jesus said, who is good? Only one person is good, that is God. So Jesus says, I am a good shepherd, that means he is also God in that sense. And also he makes a distinction between good shepherd and bad shepherd. The good shepherd is the owner of the sheep. He loves them, he gives them name. Even if he has 100 or more sheep, he has an individual name for each sheep, just like parents have a name for each child. And he takes care of them, and he loves them, and they love him. That is why Jesus said, I know them and they know me. And also, he compares that to the hired people, because the hired people are only working at the interest of the owner to get them some payment. So they don't love them as their own, because they are not their own. So when Jesus says, I'm not like the hired men, these hired men were the Pharisees, the scribes, the chief priests of that time, because they were interested in their own interest rather than the welfare of the people. They were not dedicating their lives for the salvation of the children, of the children of God. And they were also not interested in uniting the Gentiles or the Samaritans or the other public sinners to the flock of God. That is why Jesus said, I have also other sheep that do not belong to this fold, and I have to bring them also. That is why when Jesus reconstituted Israel as the church, he allowed not only the Jews, but all walks of people who are willing to reconcile. And then the shepherd means, in the Old Testament times, there were shepherds. They were taking care of the lamb, because traditionally there were two types of living. For example, Cain was taking care of farming, and Abel was taking care of the sheep. And sheep is a very delicate, very innocent animal, and it doesn't fight with the wolf or any other wild beast that come to attack them, and they might get dispersed. So the shepherd make use of two things, the rod and the staff. The staff is like the staff that the bishops use, and the rod is a strong stick that he used to attack the enemies, like the wolf or the thieves. When they come to steal or to attack the sheep, he will use a rod, and then he uses a staff to guide the sheep. And so when we say in Psalm 23, King David heard this psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. So in the Old Testament times, God is considered as the shepherd of the people. So the relationship between God and Israel were used by some examples that ordinary people could understand, like God is the husband and Israel was the wife, or the Israelites were the firstborn children of God the Father, or Israel as the vineyard and God is the owner who takes good care of Israel, and also the shepherd and the sheep. So even if I walk in the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, because the rod and staff of God gives them courage, the strength, because God is our protector and God is the guide. So we have to follow the guidance of God, and we have to depend on the protection of God. So also in the New Testament, Jesus and his relationship with church are compared like a bride and the groom. Jesus is the bride, the groom, and church is the bride, and the full union will be happening at the second coming of Christ. And we are the children of the church and Jesus Christ. And he is also considered himself as an elder brother for us, and we are in a way brothers of Jesus Christ, because of the freedom he gave us to call God as our Father. And the church is also considered as the vineyard, the new vineyard that Jesus is taking care of through his church. And also he said, I am the shepherd, and the people are the faithful, are the sheep. So God, Jesus is taking care of the God's people, and God is the owner of all the sheep. And since Jesus is Son of God, he is also the owner, and he is not a hired person. And so those owners, they dedicate their lives for the welfare of their children. And for example, there is a story of Saint Mark. Saint Mark was he's an evangelist, but not one of the 12 apostles. He wrote the gospel. His mother was Mary, and she was very devoted to Jesus, and that is why the Passover was celebrated. That was at their upper room. So Mark's house was used for Passover. And also, whenever Jesus goes there into Jerusalem, since that was in Jerusalem, they could meet there. And also, even after the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, Jesus appeared to them when they were also in that room. And so, Mark's mother was a devoted disciple of Jesus, but the father was pagan, and he had no faith in Jesus Christ. And once they were both walking, Mark and his father, the pagan father, were walking in Jerusalem, that outside the Jerusalem, two lions came, the male and female, and they were going to attack them. And then the father said, do one thing, son, you are young, so you have to leave. Then the lions will attack both of us. So better that you run away and I stay here, so that the lion let it kill me and eat, rather than attacking both of us. And then Mark did not agree with that. Mark said, no, Father, I will pray to Jesus. And he prayed, and the lions died, and so they were not attacked. And the pagan father was also converted to Christianity. So that is a story that was recommended not in the gospel, but outside. However, here the importance is that sometimes parents are even willing to die for the welfare of their children. Sometimes a pregnant lady will be asked by the gynecologist, you know, I cannot save both the mother and the child. Either the mother or the child can be saved. Usually what the mother says is that, let my child be saved, and I am willing to die for the life of my child. So Jesus is saying that I am willing to die for the people, my sheep that are entrusted to me by my Father. There is another story in the Bible about King David. Before he became king, he was anointed by Samuel the prophet according to the direction of God. And the Israelites were threatened by Philistines. And the warrior main person was a giant Goliath. And Israelites could not defeat him. And so David came and approached Saul that I can go and attack this man. And Saul was surprised. This is a young boy. How can he go and kill this big Goliath? All the soldiers of Israelites failed to attack him. And then what did David say? That is recorded in the first book of Samuel, chapter 17, verses 34 onwards. David said to Saul, your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. So this can be later applied to Jesus. So Jesus, the servant of God, he has been keeping the father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. So Jesus said, here he says, even if he has thousands of sheep and only one is attacked by the wolf or the lion, then he will go after that and rescue that that lamb from the beast. And so also Jesus said, even if I have 100 sheep and one is lost, I will go after that one lost sheep. And when it turned on me, I seized it by its hair, struck it and killed it. Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. So he's a good shepherd, literally a good shepherd, because he was even attacking the lion or the bear or a wolf that came to catch the lamb. So also Jesus says, I'm the good shepherd. I'm like King David. I'm going to protect you from the evil. And what is the evil? The Satan. And so that is the role of Jesus Christ. So Jesus says, like a parent, they know me and I know them. So it is not a property. He considers us his own. So the children are the parents consider us their own, because it's a part of their existence. And so also Jesus says, these people belong to me and they know me. And so Jesus is a good shepherd. And then another aspect is that Jesus said, he's the Lamb of God. That is how John the Baptist introduced Jesus. He is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. So in the Old Testament times, lambs were sacrificed in the temple. For what? To take away the sins of the people. But those lambs were taking away the sins of these, our own sins, but not the original sin. Only one lamb can take away the original sin, that is Jesus. So Jesus is considered also as the Lamb of God. That is why we have the picture of a lamb here, the victorious lamb that was slain, which symbolizes Jesus Christ. So Jesus is one way a sheep, and another way he is a shepherd. And that is the same call for us. We have to be like a sheep, sacrificing ourselves for the salvation of ourselves and for the liberation of other people. And we have to lead other people as a good shepherd. So Jesus showed us through his life as an example of how we should be a good shepherd, because he died to convince us that we have to fight the evil. There is no compromise with the evil at the time of his temptation. Then we love from the heart. out of the love from the heart, he even was willing at last to open his heart for us and accept failures of the world, because Jesus was from the worldly point of view an utter failure, because he was crucified, which is a very humiliating death that Jesus faced, and very painful one rather than any human person experience. But that was not a failure, but there was a victory after that. So if one is voluntarily dedicating his life for the welfare of his own family, for the people whom he serve or she serve, or people who are in need of, people who are poor, people who need salvation, then we will seem like a failure in this world, but we will be victorious in the world to come. So that motivated the early Christians and modern missionaries also to dedicate their lives for the welfare of other people. So we have to be true shepherds following the example of Jesus Christ. So we have to follow the current shepherds are the bishops, their representatives, and those who cooperate with them. There can be people who are dressed like a sheep, but they are wolves, and they can mislead us. And so we have to be careful. So let us ask God's grace that we be the true sheep, observing the guidance of Jesus Christ, and also shepherd, taking care of the people entrusted to our care.